The December Pixel feature drop for the Pixel 6 and the Pixel 6 Pro is finally here. Hey peeps, what's up? Manji here, back with another video and the update which a lot of Pixel 6 and Pixel 6 Pro owners have been waiting for, which is the December feature drop, is finally here and I am running it on my Pixel 6 Pro. Now, there are some high expectations from this specific feature drop because the Pixel 6 and the 6 Pro do have their issues and people are hoping that some of them would be addressed with this specific build. And Google does have a pretty big list of around 80 to 100 bug fixes which they have done for this specific build. Now, let us first talk about what is not fixed. So, is the 5G battery drain fixed? No, that issue is not yet fixed. Then, is the issue of LDAC and Bluetooth at 990 kbps fixed? No, that issue is still not fixed either, and there are reports of Bluetooth stuttering as well. Then, is the issue of grainy front camera preview? Again, only the preview is grainy, the final product is good, but is that specific issue of grainy front camera in the preview fixed? No, that issue is not fixed either. And last but not the least, is your always on display with this LTPO panel resting at 10 hertz or say 20 or 30 or 48? No, we are still at 120. Can you watch your Formula One videos with the screen at 50? No, it is still at 60. So those issues have not been fixed. Has the FOD or the under display fingerprint scanner, as Google prefers to call it, has that been fixed? Well, reports are that it is working better, but for me personally, I think it is still the same and people are reporting it working better with screen protectors. Now, it might be a placebo effect, and if you do have one of these devices with the December update, do let me know via comments below what do you feel about the fingerprint scanner with this specific update. Now, a bug fix which I have noticed is that previously with these two options turned off, tap to check and lift to check, even the slightest movement would wake up the display, and that issue has finally been fixed with the December feature drop for the Pixel 6 and the Pixel 6 Pro. The next change you will notice is that when you boot your device, the Google logo in the boot animation adapts to the Material U colors of your wallpaper. And while we are talking about the Material U colors, an important thing you will note is that for the same wallpaper, you now have multiple options, or you have a bunch of different options. So I will have screenshots here. Let us go into landscapes and use this one and apply it. Now, once I have applied it, and we can go back and check out the Material U colors which are available for this specific wallpaper, and as you can see, here are the different color choices available for this specific wallpaper, which is different than the previous build which we had. We can try out another one of the balloon wallpapers or a hot air balloon wallpaper, which should be here somewhere. So here it is. These are the Material U color options available with this hot air balloon wallpaper setup right now, and you will see the color options or the Material U colors prior to this specific update on the left hand side of the screen. Next up, while we are talking about the previews, let me go ahead and add a clock widget to my home screen so that I can show you another small difference or another bug which they have fixed. So herein I do have a clock widget. Let me go into wallpapers and style, change the wallpaper. Let us go into curated culture. Now, for starters, you do have three new wallpapers with this specific build on top. These are the three new wallpapers, and when I open the preview, you will notice that the widget is there and the clock is ticking. On the previous build, it would just show up as loading, so that issue has also been fixed. Next up, the internet card has gotten a Material U update. So if I access my quick settings now, for starters, you will notice that I do have the time, even though the quick settings are not expanded. Previously, you would get the time when it was expanded, but now you get the time besides the date on the top left, even when it is not expanded. And if I tap on the internet tile, here it is. You can see that it has now gotten a material U update and the toggle is a bit different. The same applies for the button on the bottom right as well. And while we are talking about the internet tile, you can now go ahead and access the internet tile and you can turn off your Wi-Fi from the lock screen as well with the latest update. Tap on done and you should be good to go. Another change you will notice is that when you access your quick settings panel, and let us say I tap on the internet tile, you will notice that the quick settings panel in the background has not disappeared. It is still there. Then if you press and hold on any widget, the options which you get on the top now have text with them, and as you can see, we have the option of remove and we also have the option of widget settings. Next up, if you press and hold on the empty space on your wallpaper, go into home settings. This page is also now material U styled and the buttons, the toggles are bigger, and home settings is now collapsible. You can see on the top, if and when I move it or scroll it, home settings is now collapsible. Next up, if you try to access your Google feed by swiping, you will notice that the wallpaper has a zoom effect. Previously, this effect was not there. There it is. You can see in the background, the wallpaper has this pretty cool looking zoom effect, which was not present in the previous build. Then with respect to your notifications, let us say you have a notification from YouTube, you press and hold on the icon on your home screen. Previously, you would not be able to dismiss the notifications. Now you should be able to dismiss and move over to the next notification from pressing and holding on the icon itself. Then there have been some changes to the system-wide search. So let us open the application drawer, and herein if I search for settings, you will notice that beside the settings icon, I have another search icon which was previously not there. If I tap on this, I can now search within the settings itself. So this is like equivalent of taking you to the settings page, and herein we can go ahead and tap on the search on the top. So those two things are now combined. If you go to your application drawer, use the system-wide search, tap on this, you are now back to the same screen. And I am not sure why these gestures are not working from this specific screen. Then another new change which I have noticed is if you try to search over here and you search for screen, it is going to show you the screenshots which you have taken. Of course, it is only capable enough of showing you the last three screenshots. Press and hold on any of them and you can now share them using the quick share menu. Now, what if you do not get this feature? Well, the workaround for that is to go into settings, apps, see all apps, and herein you need to search for Pixel Launcher. Once you see Pixel Launcher, you will have to go into storage and cache and clear the storage. The only downside of this is that you are going to lose your home screen layout, the icons, whatever changes you have made, all of those will be lost. Next change which I have noticed is if you go into settings and then you go into display. Herein, for the option of auto rotate screen, previously you would have to go inside the option, then enable it. Face detection is automatically enabled, but now you have the toggle on the outside itself without having to go in. So you only have to go into enable or disable the toggle for face detection, and the quick setting tile also tells you whether face based auto rotate is on or off. And while we are in display, if you go into colors and try to switch between the natural, boosted and adaptive colors, you now have three different options to check out the changes and how it looks. Previously, there was only one image and that image is no longer a part of these three images. Then they have also added favorites to now playing. So if you go into settings, sound and vibration, now playing, and once you have enabled this, go into now playing history, you will see you have the option of favorites. Any songs which you favorite, you will have icons beside the song, a heart icon, tap on it and those songs are going to show in your favorites section. Then those of you who use the power button to invoke the assistant, if you go into settings, system, gestures, and herein we can go into press and hold power button. Once you enable the toggle, you can now adjust the press and hold duration using the slider, and you have options of long, and the intensity keeps on decreasing as you keep on going towards the left of the screen. And last but not the least, they have added some Snapchat integration to the double tap on the back feature. So again, settings, system, gestures, quick tap once it is enabled, and you go into the open app section, go into settings. If you have Snapchat installed, you can always go into the settings for Snapchat, and you are going to get multiple options about what you want to do when you double tap on the back with respect to the Snapchat application. So what is my personal take on this December feature drop? Well, my personal take is that they have fixed some issues, but the major issues of 5G battery drain, your Bluetooth stutter, the front camera having a grainy preview. I mean, come on, this is a $900 flagship device from the likes of Google. You make Android, and Android on your specific device is not perfect. I mean, what else can I say about that? So that will do it for this video. Hope my video helped you. Likes, shares, and subscribes are appreciated. Feedback and comment more than welcome. See you when I see you.